Moment!
What's our course, Captain?
Principe, quartermaster. We're sailing for the coast of Africa.
Fire, sir!
Shit!
Talk to us, we got it!
Now ye all have to die!
Fire!
Fire! Fire! Fire! Fire!
Let us to sail! Get up to planks!
Loose topsails, gallants, and royals!
Shorten sail! Get off the squall! Foremast grounded, all on!
Loose tops and royals!
The gallants and royals!
Hearty now, Mitra!
As much sail as you can!
Loose topsails, gallants and royals!
Ease off the wind!
Reef the mains!
Haul them in! Get off the wind!
I'm off to find Roberts.
Don't stay long. Crew's getting restless out here.
Captain Kenway. Yet another dire situation, Roberts. We really must stop meeting like this.
Stop tailing me and your wish had come true.
There's no need for this. You know I'm as good as my word.
Our Captain Howell was killed today in a Portuguese ambush. Headstrong fool. I warned him not to go ashore.
It was orchestrated by the Templars, Burgers, and Cockrum. The same sort that took you to Havana.
Ah, I see now there is no escaping the Templars' attention, is there? I suppose it is time to fight back.
I do like the sound of that.
And I know just how I'll do it. But these men, Burgess and Cockrum, they cannot be allowed to leave with word of my escape.
They won't. Count on it.
If you spot any men from my crew, do them some kindness and send them here.
I'll do all I can.
Mm-hmm.
No one. Take only what you can carry, maggots. We're not waiting on no one.
What do you like after death?
You done us good, Kenway. Proved yourself a true bravo. And for what?
His own bloody pride.
You stepped in the path of my prize. Not a thing a man should do.
A cocksure, Cully? Just like Hornigold said.
That Templar scab means nothing to me. None of you do.
And you're worse for it, Kenway. It were the Templars who took us in when all else went to shit. Not our king. Not our country. The Templars.
The Templars is our family. Where's yours?
In honest service, there are thin commons, low wages. Yet, as gentlemen of fortune, we enjoy plenty and satisfaction, pleasure and ease, liberty and power. So what man with a sensible mind would choose the former life, when the only hazard we pirates run is a sour look from those without strength or splendor? Now, I have been among you 6 weeks, and in that time, I have adopted your outlook as my own, and with so fierce a conviction that it may frighten you to see your passions reflected from me in so stark a light. But if it's a captain you see in me now, why then, I'll be your bloody captain.
For I have dipped my hands in muddied waters, and, withdrawing them, find 'tis better to be a commander than a common man.
You fatten with your resistance.
I'm looking for the observatory. Folks say you're the only man that can find it.
Folks are correct. Despite my distaste for your eagerness, I see in you a touch of untested genius. I'm Bartholomew Roberts.
Edward.
I've no secrets to share with you now. But if you'll lend me your aid, in 2 months' time, west of the Leeward Islands, well, it's there you'll get some answers, I promise you.
Funny that. With scurvy, the fix is more pleasant than the cause. When you catch a dose from a horn, must treat it with quicksilver. You're fonder of getting the disease than you are of curing it. Something biting at you.
Oh, all men desire to live by a code or a creed, yes? Yet when pressed, most defer to their instincts rather than the laws that bind them. What is the appeal of a creed if it does not yoke all men to like behavior?
Might make a man feel like he belongs to something. What's your answer?
Oh, that all men are sheep. That an old wolf like me deserves every ounce of blood he draws. Sail to this location. Bring only those you trust.